Ears are responsible for capturing sound and turning it into signals your child's brain can understand. You can see ears on the outside, but there are actually many parts that work together so your child can hear. There are three parts to the ear: the outer, middle, and inner ear. The pinna, or auricle, catches sound and directs it into the ear canal. The eardrum separates the outer and middle ear. The eardrum vibrates when sound hits it. Soft sounds vibrate it a little bit, and loud sounds vibrate it a lot. High-pitched sounds vibrate it quickly, and low-pitched sounds vibrate it slowly. When your doctor looks in your child's ear, they can see their eardrum. The middle ear includes the eustachian tube, which connects the middle ear to the back of the throat, and the ossicles, the three bones of the middle ear, the malleus, incus, and stapes. Also called the hammer, anvil, and stirrup, they are the smallest bones in the body. As the eardrum moves, it vibrates the ossicles. The ossicles transfer those vibrations to the inner ear through the oval window and the round window. One part of the inner ear includes the semicircular canals, which work with your child's eyes, brain, and feet to help them balance. The cochlea is the other part of the inner ear, and it looks like a snail's shell. Inside, the cochlea is filled with fluid and lined with special hair cells. When the fluid in the cochlea vibrates, hair cells turn those vibrations into nerve signals. High-pitched sounds are picked up by the hair cells at the beginning of the spiral. Low-pitched sounds are picked up by the hair cells at the end of the spiral. The signals from the cochlea travel along the hearing nerve to the brain. Your child's brain understands those signals and recognizes them as sounds